live streaming used to be a pretty complicated feature to build into your applications, but not anymore. With the use of Mux's simple APIs, you can start building live streaming features into your application in just a few minutes. In this video, we're going to talk through three different steps that you'll need to take to build out live streaming features into your app. The first is create a unique live stream. Then we're going to start streaming to that live stream. And then finally, we'll figure out how to play back that live stream in your own video player. Let's get started in the Mux dashboard by going to create a brand new access token that we can use with the Mux API. I'm heading down to the corner settings and choosing access tokens. And I want to click on the generate new token button. First, we'll want to select the environment that we're working within. We only need permissions to work with muxvideo in this particular use case. You can change the name of your access token if it's helpful, and click generate token. So we'll need both of these values to create the live stream. Make sure to copy them and paste them somewhere safe. You can also click the green button to download the environment variables file. Cool, so now we're ready to start writing a little bit of code. I'm in a brand new project in my editor, and the approach that I'll take for this particular demo is to create a Node.js file that will interact with the Mux API and create the resources that we need to start live streaming. So we'll have one main entry file, and I'll call that index.js, and this file will perform the actions that we need to get up and running. To make working with the Mux API super easy, we can install the Mux Node SDK into our project. You don't need to be using JavaScript for your project. You can be using any language that is right for your application. So now looking at the project structure, we have a package.json file, an index.js, and our associated packages. That's all great, but we really only need a few lines of code to get started here. So the first thing I want to do is import the Mux Node SDK that we just installed to this project. Perfect, and now we'll need to instantiate it using those environment variables that contain the access token and the secret key that we created within the Mux dashboard. I downloaded the environment variables over here, and I'm gonna go ahead and copy this file right over to our project. Back over in our index.js file, we can create a new instance of the Mux Node SDK by instantiating it and assigning it to a variable. We'll call this variable Mux in this case. You'll see we're loading the Mux token ID and Mux token secret from the process.env object. To make sure we're appropriately loading our .env file, I'm going to use the .env package to ensure we're loading those variables correctly. So I'll go over to the CLI and I'll do npm install .env. And I'll just add this little config line of code here at the top. Perfect. Now we're ready to start interacting with the Mux API. First thing we'll want to do is create the actual live stream. So this basically acts as a container for the live stream itself. When we create a live stream, nothing's going to go live automatically or by default, but we'll have the option to turn that live stream on or off when we are ready to publish live video. To create a new live stream, it only takes a few lines of code. We'll provide a playback policy, which basically says anybody can access this particular live stream by calling it a public playback policy. And we'll also say that the new asset that's created as a result of going live can be accessed by anyone as well. Every live stream is automatically recorded and archived into Mux so that you can play it back at a future time. Because this is an async operation, I'm going to wrap it in an async function. Now, the last thing to consider is that this code will typically be running on your server as a result of a request that was made by one of your users. Maybe they clicked a button to say, create a new live stream, or perhaps you create a live stream automatically when a new user signs up. So this code won't typically be running in a CLI environment, but the whole interaction process is the same idea where this code will run as a result of your application taking action. One other small refactor to make sure that this runs appropriately in the CLI environment is to just change this import method to, let's say, const mux equals require mux node. Let's give this a shot. I'm gonna head over to the CLI and run node index.js. and it looks like our .m file is not loading appropriately. So we'll make one more change here to make sure that that gets loaded in. To make sure our environment variables get picked up, I'm going to just rename this file from the original name to simply .env. Now we should be ready to go. I'm going to head over to the CLI and run the script. Great, you can see that our script executed successfully. We have an interesting payload that was returned as a result of running that request. This payload contains all of the information that we need to be able to turn this live stream on and off when we're ready to. Most importantly is the stream key. This is basically a password that allows you to connect to this live stream container and send live videos that will then be broadcast to wherever this live stream is meant to be played. You can also see that the live stream status is idle because we're not currently sending any live video. Let's go ahead and change that. This stream key value is going to be commonly used between all of the different live streaming applications out there, whether that's OBS, Restream, StreamYard, or whatever other live stream application you might be using. For this demo, I'm going to use OBS. I'll copy the stream key, head on over to OBS, go into the preferences, and under the stream tab, I'll be able to choose the service that I'm going to be streaming through. You can find Mux in the list of services. In the stream key field, simply paste the stream key that was returned as a result of making the API request. Then click OK. We're all configured to start our live streaming, so I'm going to go ahead and click Start Streaming. Now let's check out the Mux dashboard and see if we can check in on our live stream. I'm going to go into my development environment, head on over to the video tab, and click on live streams. Looks like we have one active live stream, which is good news, and there's me in that yellow hat. Seems to be working. So our live video was delivered into Mux successfully. That's great news, but we probably aren't going to be playing back the live stream within the Mux dashboard every time. We want our viewers to be able to load up this live stream and watch it as we stream live. So let me show you how to load this live stream into a player that you can then place on your own website. If you go to the Playback and Thumbnails tab, you'll see a playback ID. Now this playback ID is basically the reference for this live stream that allows you to load it up in any of the video players that are out there. One of the easiest ways to playback your live stream is by using Mux Player. You can just copy and paste this code that's given to you right on this dashboard page, and you should be able to see this live stream load up with no problems. I'm going to click on this little clipboard to copy this code, head on over to a new code sandbox, and in the body, I'll go ahead and paste our Mux Player code. Cool, and you can see the video that we were live streaming is now appearing right on the website. So that's it. Really, with just a few lines of code, we were able to create a new live stream and then show you how to take that stream key, plug it into your video streaming application, and go live without a hitch. Then we can take that playback ID that was created and throw it into Mux Player to watch the live stream across all the different devices that are out there. Now you're ready to get up and running with your live stream. Let us know if you have any questions along the way. We're here to help.